Even more alarming, he is a convicted felon. So why was he allowed to drive a cab in the city at all? Volusia County Bureau Chief Claire Matz has the big story right now from Daytona Beach.
And he wrestled the money bag away from me. Because
Main Street barber Ray Branton actually knows the man who threw him to the ground at closing time Wednesday night and stole a week's worth of haircut work. Branton has helped 41-year-old Mike Olensky out in the past when Olensky was down on his luck.
So he ran to the cab and I went through here.
But that night, police say Olensky, who was off work, lurked in this alcove. His cab, Olensky works for the American Taxi Company, was parked down the street. Apparently, he was just waiting for Ray and over $1,100 cash.
And as long as he wasn't on crack, he was all right. But he got out there working and got back in that neighborhood that he goes in and back into the drugs.
We checked. Olensky has a criminal record, and the folks at American Taxi say they don't hire convicted felons. The owner says Olensky had worked here just 2 or 3 days and that the results of his background check were not back to him when the alleged robbery occurred. The owner claims Olensky had a city permit like this one to drive a cab, which would have required a city background check. And city codes don't allow felons to drive cabs. The city hasn't been able to tell us if Olensky was permitted, but the police chief is fuming.
He could pick up anybody and rob them.
Mike Chitwood says if Olensky fell through the cracks, it's a disgrace.
Every night at bar closing, I have them out there picking up drunken females when they come out of a club, taking a ride home. Who knows what tragedy could be on our hands.
Police made Olensky a priority. Tonight he's off the streets, but the investigation is far from over. In Daytona Beach, Volusia County.